Y'all, it's Hallelujah, Jeremiah back at y'all. Today's another motherfucking leg day. Today's gonna be a real good day. I got this quote from Atomic Habits. Every action you take is a vote for the person you're trying to become. So I like that a lot. So I gotta be real focused on my next step. I'm staying focused, enjoying the process. Every action you take is a vote for the person you want to become. Leg day, let's get it.
It's my own ball, baby. Treat me the way you wanna do. It's my own ball, baby. Treat me the way you wanna do. God's when you were loving me, baby. Oh, I'm dying without I didn't love you. This is what I like. She used to make her own paychecks and bring them all home to me. I would go out on the hillside, you know, and make every woman drunk I see. It's my own fault, baby. Treat me the way you wanna do.
Message over. strike chord. I'm like years ahead of you niggas. That's why we got more than you ever learned. This is my spot, now you better wait your turn. 10AK, yo, shit, that's irrelevant. Can't hide the fact that I'm intelligent. Street smart, what a little book says. A young nigga with a lot of common sense. They say I'm shallow, but I think so deep. How deep? Deep is the abyss. So when you get a minute, take a look at my wrist. I suck hypnotized, you're hypnotized. Hypnotized, you're hypnotized. Yeah, I'm big old wheels. A thousand now with the dreams and mills. Spend grand at the mall, yeah, just for thrills. Shit, I get it right back, nigga, that's for real. It's all in the game, free throws and fouls. Half a mil in the basement, goddamn, I'm flavored. I want it all, no matter the cost. Cook the consequences, ain't nothing to a boss. Made a lot out of a little, something not enough. I'm so proud of me, put the streets on top where they supposed to be. The sky is the limit, that's what Jesus said. In the limit of the sky, let's slice that pie. So, hypnotize, you're hypnotized. Hypnotize, you're hypnotized. Hypnotize, you're hypnotized. Hypnotize, you're hypnotized. Now I command you niggas to get money. 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 Hypnotize, we're hypnotized. Hypnotize, we're hypnotized. Hypnotize, we're hypnotized.
Long rod. I'm gonna let you guys in on a private personal part of my life. And ladies, listen up, I may just say it in a relationship.
They took a dick from California, then can't get a motherfucker to watch the DC and get from the nation.
just another day in office. Yeah, but them niggas should be so good, be driving crazy than a motherfucker, man. Niggas, I'm down 84, doing things, always talking about that. This how we drive on the phone, man, you know. Doing donuts and shit, and all up in the prairie, running up new cars and shit, man. Really don't know what you told me, shit, bitch. It was me, Jack, Bean, and T-Lo. Boom, cookie, slow motion, and P.O. Spud, Juju, Frog, and Finny. Getting high on Oral Street. Bugs away, 6 in the morning. Rolling broke deep from the train park. Power came through from the D-Town. Motherfucking heat eyes going down. It's the same every day, every day is the same. But that ain't like hit the whole game. See how the words go straight.
Anything, because you don't know what you want. And so if I can do one thing for you when you leave this room, I don't want nothing from you but for you to leave this room and know what you want. What do you want in your marriage? What do you want with your son and your daughter? What do you want in your health? What do you want financially? Like, how much money do you want to make a year? What do you want to drive? How do you want to live? Stop just waking up like an accident. What do you want? And then once you find out what you want, spend the rest of your natural life waking up and going after it. The reason why I speak with so much passion. E.T., why do you speak with so much authority? Because I'm talking about my life, not something that I read. I ate out of trash cans. I had no business eating out of trash cans. I lived in abandoned buildings. I had no business living in abandoned buildings. But E.T., your daddy wasn't your life. Your mom was a teenage mother. You grew up, come on, E, look at your shirt. That's not an excuse. There is no excuse for not living up to your fullest potential. No excuse. I told you, I didn't get a... Yep, I need the all blacks. I need the all, why? Because they say what I'm saying. They just said it in rugby. I don't doubt it. I'm like, ooh, that's a violent sport. Their passion is all over there. Why? Because winners win. I can't explain it to you, but you better stop making excuses and find a way to win. Because once you start winning, you go from 1,500 to 3,000 to 5,000 to 7,000. You remember, C? From 7 to 10. Nothing changed. We still in the basement. We don't have a building. We still use the garage for all of our products. We don't have business cards. We don't have a 5-year plan. We don't have a 3-year plan. How do you do it then? We wake up and grind. Winners win. I focus more on winning than I focus on structure. I focus on winning. And when you become a winner, they start seeing you with winners. You get from being a loser, low self-esteem, doubt, and fear.
Focus more on their distractions rather than their destiny. People that are hungry, they don't care. They're focused on what they need to do to be here. They're going to keep social distance from not only the virus and people in social situations. situations. They're going to limit themselves, leaving the house, leaving only when it's necessary, and social distancing from negative, toxic, energy, unproductive people. You want to make it now, you want to get around the right people virtually. Virtually. You want to get where they are with what they have. They're always looking for a way to win. They don't use excuses. They're the first ones there and the last ones to leave. I just let someone go today. I love this person. Good people. But ain't hungry. I was in radio. I was the first one there and the last one to leave. I opened the station up and I closed it. We're living in a time where 9 to 5 is gone. Now you got to work from 5 until you faint. If you're hungry, trifling there were people that he was leading. I text him back, I haven't heard from him. I say, the speed of the leader, the speed of the group. They're a reflection of you. You're pointing at them, but you got 3 fingers pointing back at yourself. I don't think you like that. Don't cast pearls before swines, lest they turn and rend you. Yeah, they get mad. They don't want to hear the truth. And I'll never forget. I was with Dr. Johnny Coleman. I graduated from the Universal Foundation for Better Living in Chicago. And I said, Dr. Coleman, I was with a group of other ministers. I said, I only have 5 people every week on a significant emotional event through this computer. How to present myself. I think Warren Buffett has a point. If you were in a dark room with a woman and you wink, nothing happens. Come on, you got to have some light of how to function in this new world. This is serious. This is very serious. Don't get so caught up in the craziness that's going on right now.
And fighting constantly to look for ways in which you can escape the inner conversation between ages 0 and 5. We determine what's available to us and what's not available to us. And so that was a defining moment. I knew there are certain things I could not do, certain places I could not go. They used to have signs on Miami Beach that said, Jews, dogs, and colors not allowed. And so now you have to operate within the constraints of the dominant society and the things that they've created for you. Making a conscious, deliberate, determined effort to think outside of what life has thrown at them, they end up doing the same thing over and over and over again. Einstein said that thinking that has brought me this far has created some problems that this thinking can't solve. And so through relationships, through reading, through studies, through goals and dreams beyond your comfort zone, it allows you to begin to live out of your imagination as opposed to out of your history. Dizzy said, the imagination is a preview of what's to only quality people. A gentleman who dramatically transformed my life, I was a junior at Booker T. Washington High School in Miami, Florida. And I went in his class looking for another friend. And he said, go to a boy and work this problem out for me. I said, sir, I can't do that. He said, why not? I said, I'm not one of your students. He said, do it anyhow. And the other kid started laughing, saying, he's Leslie. He's DT. And he said, what's DT? His brother is smart, but he's the dumb twin. And beyond your comfort zone and having relationships that will challenge you and surrounding yourself with coaches and mentors who can take you to a place within yourself that you can't go by yourself because you can't read the label when you're locked in the box. And so those experiences, they challenge you to go to that next level and continue to move forward in your life, doing new and exciting things that eye has not seen, ear has not heard, nor is it in the heart of mankind what God has in store for you when you live a hard-centered life, deciding that you're going to live a life that will outlive you. You're going to live a life that counts, a life that will build a legacy and change the planet. You know, Horace Mann said, we should be ashamed to die. That Sidney Poitier wrote a book called The Measure of a Man. And he said, when you go for a walk with someone, something happens without being spoken. He said, either you adjust to their pace or they adjust to your pace. Whose pace have you adjusted to? And so there are things that we pick up and we think that they're our door. But if you know marketing, people will sleep outside your store to buy a telephone they've never touched or seen.
People see me, but they think of you. Now with all this going on, this is going to be worse than ever.
It don't have to be.
No, sure it does.
Why? You got a lot going on, kid.
Oh, well, my last name? That's the reason I got a decent job. That's the reason why people deal with me in the first place. Now I start to get a little ahead. I start to get a little something for myself. And this happens. Now I'm asking you as a... Do you?
You ain't gonna believe this. But you used to fit right here. I'd hold you up and say to your mother, this kid's gonna be the best kid in the world. This kid's gonna be somebody better than anybody ever knew. And you grew up good and wonderful. And when things got hard, you started looking for something to blame, like a big shadow. Let me tell you something you already know. The world ain't all sunshine and rainbows. It's a very mean and nasty place, and I don't care how tough you are, it will beat you to your knees and keep you there permanently if you let it. You, me, or nobody is going to hit as hard as life. But it ain't about how hard you hit. It's about how hard you can get hit and keep moving forward. How much you can take and keep moving forward. That's how winning is done. Now, if you know what you're worth, then go out and get what you're worth. But you got to be willing to take the hits and not pointing fingers saying you ain't where you want to be because of him or her or anybody. Cowards do that, and that ain't you. You're better than that.